comes on the heels of a similar situation involving an OHP trooper. 2 News investigator Marla Carter continues our team coverage tonight, examining the hiring process for both the Oklahoma Highway Patrol and the Tulsa County Sheriff's Office. Marla?
Karen, the 2 News investigators have been digging into the hiring practice of law enforcement agencies across Oklahoma. And what we found? The Tulsa County Sheriff's Office says after this recent incident, it's now going to be evaluating its policy.
It's an honor to wear the badge of law enforcement, and with power comes immense responsibility. With 2 arrests in just 2 days of men sworn to serve and protect, accused of abusing that power, the 2 News investigators went digging into what agencies require when it comes to hiring. As for the Tulsa County Sheriff's Office,
well, there's a testing component, there's a background investigation, there's a psychological exam, there's a drug screen, there's an interview process.
But does it go far enough? Even the undersheriff admits it needs some examination after recent events.
When you have an incident like this, you have to look at the totality of the incident. From the time this guy was hired to when this happened, you've got to look at the entire, and training is a big part of that. Policy and training will be a big part of that. So yeah, we'll certainly examine that.
This follows the arrest of Trooper Eric Roberts. He's accused of sexually assaulting 3 women during traffic stops. OHP says it also does extensive background checks and takes complaints seriously.
But we think it's very important as an agency with the kind of public trust and the public institution that we are as the Highway Patrol, that the public has confidence in us knowing that we police our own.
The Oklahoma State Bureau of Investigation also has a very rigorous hiring process. In fact, they tell us that it takes months to complete, including a polygraph exam and background checks. Reporting live from near downtown Tulsa, Marla Carter, 2 News Works for You.
Thank you, Marla. Now, between 2010 and 2013, 26 law enforcement officers in Oklahoma were convicted of or pleaded guilty to sex crimes, 8 of those just last year. Now, finding this information wasn't easy. We discovered the Council on Law Enforcement and Education is the state's only agency collecting that type of data. It only collects convictions, not how many officers are arrested or charged with sex crimes. And it doesn't break down the number by the type of sex crime or whether it occurred on or off duty. Now,